Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Hope all of you will be enjoying good health. Dear students, as you can see, I have got general science book for you for class 6. So what we are going to do, we will open the very first chapter. Okay, the very first chapter here is about cellular organization of plants and animals. Okay, this is our chapter number 1. So the diagram here shows millions of blood cells are running in the blood vessels of our body. You can see the blood that is running in your body, it has got these cells, and the shape of the cells is like this. So what are the learning outcomes of this chapter? We will learn more about cell. You must have already learned about cell, its structure in your previous class, but in this class you will learn a little bit more about it, a little bit more description about it. Then you will learn about microscope, its different parts, their functions, then the difference between animal and plant cell. Then we have got unicellular and multicellular organisms, systems in plants, and major systems in human body. So we are going to learn all these things in this chapter. So turn on the next page, page number 4, and we will start our reading from this page. You will open your book in front of you and you will read it out. You will do the silent reading with me. Okay, so when we look at a brick house, we can easily see that the bricks are small units in it. Like a brick house, all living things or organisms are made of very small units. So students, you must have seen few walls, and the building unit of those walls are bricks. I have made a structure of wall for you. These are the bricks, okay? We used to make a wall, use plaster between these bricks, and we can make a wall. Okay, so for any building there are blocks or bricks like these which we can use to build that whole building. So to build it, we are going to use these bricks. So these bricks are called the building units. Likewise, in all living things organisms have very small units. In this chapter, we shall discuss about these small units of living organisms. And what are these units? We call them cell. Okay, so for a wall, you use bricks to construct a wall. Okay, to build a wall, you need bricks. Likewise, for the building of body, we need cells. Cells are the unit, the basic unit. All living organisms are made of cells. You must be aware of it, that all living organisms, whether they are plants, animals, humans, they are made of cells. A cell is the basic unit of structure and function of all living organisms. Okay, so cell is not only a unit that build that structure, the structure of a body, but it also performs different functions. Due to the combined action of these all functions that are performed by our cell, we are able to perform our functions. We used to run, we walk, we eat, we write. So we can do all these things due to the functions of the combined action of functions of our cells. Plants and animals are made of trillion of cells. Trillion, it is such a big number that we cannot even imagine about it. So that cell is too small, we cannot see it. So you can imagine ke how many number of cells will combine together to form a body of plant or cell. Some living organisms consist of only one cell. For example, bacteria. So you must have heard about bacteria, okay? Bacteria are not good for us, they are parasites. So the size of bacteria is what? They consist of only one cell. Okay, they are so small. Cells are different in sizes, shapes, and functions. According to the functions, cells are different. They have got different size, they have got different shapes because they have to perform different functions. So here we have a diagram. In this diagram figure, we have got a human body and we have told that how many types of cells we have. These are few examples. There are more types of cells, but we are considering right now these six. So let's start from the head. In our head, we have got nerve cells. Nerve cells conduct messages. So nerve cells are present throughout the body. They take message from the body part to the cell and brain. From body parts to the brain and then bring back the reply of brain to the body part. Okay, so this is the duty of nerve cells. So basically the function of nerve cell is what? Messages. Okay, to deliver message from brain to the body and then the body to brain. Here you can see the structure of nerve cell. Okay, this is the structure of nerve cell. These are present throughout the body. Next, what we have got white blood cells. As you can see, we have mentioned here blood cells. So in blood, there are not only red blood cells, but there are few other types of cells as well. We have got white blood cells. They fight against germs that cause disease. These are very important because if some bacteria or some germ enters our body, they fight against it and they protect our body from the harmful effects of those germs and bacteria. Okay, so these are called white blood cells. Next we have red blood cells. These cells give color our blood the red color. Okay, so red color of the blood is due to the red blood cells. They transport oxygen around the body. As you people know that we need oxygen to live, and that oxygen is being provided to all parts of our body, all the cells present in our body, by the help of these red blood cells which are present in our blood. If I can show you over here the last page, here you can see we have got these cells, disc-shaped cells. These are called what? These are our red blood cells. Okay. So next, what we have? We have got muscle cells. You must be aware of muscle cells. You have already learned about it in your previous class, the whole muscular system. So the muscle cells contract and bring about movement. So you people must have seen the piece of chicken piece or a piece of mutton. You must have observed lines in it. Okay, lines. If you just take a look at a piece of meat, you can observe these kind of lines in it. Okay, so what are these lines? These are lines are basically the muscle cells. Okay, so here you can see, you must have to observe it. Okay, take a piece of chicken, chest piece must be more clear, and you will see that it has got thread-like lines in it. And if you take a cooked piece of chicken, you can observe it has got a lots of thread-like structure in it. What we call them muscle cells. So what is the function of muscle cells? They contract and bring about movement. So what is the function of muscle cells is that they contract, relax, and they help in movement. So I can show you in my hand like this. If I want to close it and then open it. So it is because of the movement of these muscle. Contract and relax. Contract and relax. Okay. So this is the action of our muscle cells. Here what we have got skin cells, covers the body and protect inner layers. As you must have seen in your hand. As you can see on my hand, you can observe I have got a skin. Okay, this skin, This skin is covering my muscles, okay? My muscles and then the veins, okay? You can see a threadwork of like veins over here, blue colored veins. So my skin is covering all these parts. Throughout my body, my skin is going to cover these and it will definitely protect all the inner layers. Whatever is the inner layer, it's muscular or it has got veins, anything. So our skin protects all these. Next, what we have? We have got our bone cells, another very important system. Bone cells produce bones to shape and support body. Okay, so you can imagine in my hand, if I don't have bones, okay, my bones are giving support and helps to move with the help of muscles. So if I don't have these bones in my hand, so you can imagine they will be loose. Okay, they will be loose and they cannot move. They will not getting any support. Okay, so our bone cells produce bones to shape and support our body. All right. So students, we have learned about nerve cells, white blood cells, red blood cells, muscle cells, bone cells, and skin cells. Let's move on to the next para. Some cells are large enough to be seen with the naked eye. That is Schoenkopf's egg. You must have eaten eggs. Okay, so I have got an egg for you as well, and I am going to show it that we have got a yellow portion in our egg. Okay, so here is our egg, a broken egg. Here you can see this yellow portion. What is this? It's a cell itself. Okay, we call it a cell. You can see it's so big that we can see it. It's too easy to see this cell, but few cells are too small that you cannot see them with your naked eye. Okay, you need certain things, equipments to see those cells, to observe those cells. But most cells are too small, okay, too small. We cannot see them with our eyes. Okay, with our normal eyes, we cannot see them. So we need a special instrument to see the cells. So if we want to observe the cells of our skin or some plants part, we need a special instrument to observe these cells. Okay, and here in the blue box, what information is being given? The term cell was first used by an English scientist Robert Hooke in 1665, long time ago. So Robert Hooke first uses the word cell because he basically discovered the cells. He observed tiny box-like structure in a thin slice of a cork under a microscope. I am going to show you that what is a cork like. As you can see here, I have got a cork, okay? The cork, we use it for different purposes. Mostly it is used to it is used as a lid to close the bottles, okay? And then we can use it in heels and in soles of certain shoes. So there are lots of uses of this cork. You can see it, okay? So this is a cork. What he did, he has taken a piece of it, okay? He has taken a piece of it, thin slice, okay? He slices bit and then observe it under a microscope. He called these structure cells, okay? And he named these smaller units cell. Which structure comes to your mind, okay? Here you can see, here is a microscope, okay? As it was quite old, so you can see it has got different kind of shape and it was too simple basically. So he observed that piece of the cork under the microscope. So he has seen a structure like this. I have made diagram for you people so that you can understand it. Here you can see this was like cork, the piece of cork he observed under the microscope. So it resembles this structure over here. Okay, so what comes to your mind? Have you ever seen a structure like this? Yes, This is what? This is a honeycomb. Okay, honeycomb. So the shape of cells in that cork piece, in that thin slice of cork piece, he observed the cells resemble to the honeycomb. Okay, you can see it here as well. And if I show you the picture once again, you can observe here. Okay, you have seen the cells over here. Okay, so they are shaped like a honeycomb. Moving on to the next page, what is our next topic? Our next topic is microscope. Okay, microscope. So what is a microscope? Microscope is an instrument which is used to see very small things that cannot be seen with naked eye. So microscope is basically an instrument which we use to see very small things, as you cannot observe the cells, the very small cells, with your naked eye. So you definitely need something to make it bigger for your eye to see, to observe it. So when we look at something through a microscope, it appears larger. You people must have got magnifying glass. So if you put a thing under that magnifying glass, you can see that if you move your magnifying glass up, it will become bigger. So microscope is something like that, but it's more sensitive and it is fine, basically, as compared to the looking, as compared to that magnifying glass. Okay, so microscope is far better as compared to the magnifying glass. The microscopes are used in our schools are light microscopes. So in our schools, the microscopes we use are called light microscopes. You can see here. These kind of microscopes we usually use in our school level. Okay, so these microscopes are light, use light to show the images. Okay, so why we call them light microscopes? Because these microscopes use light. Okay, they use light to enlarge the cells, the size of cells or whatever we are examining. A light microscope has a base. As you can see here, it has a base, okay, base, and then it has an arm, okay, an arm. Here you can see a curved kind of portion, arm, a tube. This is what we call a tube, okay, and a stage. This is the stage. Basically, this is the point where you can put the slide of your cell, whatever you want to look. Into adjustment screws. Here we have got screws. We use them to adjust according to your eye, okay, and according to the light or the size of the cell on the slide. Two lenses are fitted on the two ends of the tube. So here you can see these are the lenses. These are fitted at the end of the tube. The lens at the end of the tube through which we observe an object is called eyepiece. This is the eyepiece. We used to put our eye on it to observe anything. Okay, so this is the eyepiece. So revise it once again. This is what? This is the base, arm, tube, adjustment screws, objective lens, stage, okay, and then we have objective lens and eyepiece. So you put these lens on the object here, which is placed here. If we place a slide over here, so you will adjust these objective lens on them and you will observe by putting your eyes on this hole, okay. So the lens near the object to be seen is called the objective lens, okay? These are called objective lens. Light is passed through the object from below using a mirror. Here you can see we have got a mirror. When we have got light, light reflects from this mirror, goes up and it enlightens this object on it, on the stage, okay? So light will come to this mirror and then it will be reflected up towards the object. Okay, so that object will become clear. It will be in the light for you to observe. So the object to be seen is placed on the glass slide. We have got a slide. It's a very thin, basically, piece of a glass. We call it slide. And then on the stage, we are going to put that slide on the stage. To focus the object clearly in the microscope, two adjustment screws are used. Okay, so you can easily adjust the tube and the lenses according to your eye, your posture, and according to the size of the object which you are going to, the cell which you are going to observe. Okay, you can adjust it accordingly. We can view an object up to the 1500 times bigger than its original size. So you can imagine if you have got a thing that is of this size, and if you enlarge it 1500 times, then you can imagine that it will be too clear for us to observe it, because we cannot see it with our naked eye. So it's large enough that we can observe it. So from original size, it will become 1500 times bigger. Okay. Most of the cells are too small to be seen without a microscope. So what did biologists do to see inside the cell? Okay. So the answer of this, you must have to find it by your own as well. Okay. And the microscope, this is quite simple, you can say the light microscope, but we have got other types of microscopes as well. Okay, so if you take a look, we have got something here as well. Okay, but first take a look this slide. Have you seen? I have told you about this glass slide. This is what we call a glass slide. Here you will do the tagging. Okay, what are you observing? And here you have got the thing that you are going to observe under this. Got it? Okay. So under the supervision of your science teacher, bring a light microscope in the class. Identify different parts of microscope. Inshallah, students, when you will come to the class, we will show you the microscope and we will show you all the parts of it, and you can observe some slides as well. Okay. So in the pink box we have, do you know? Nowadays, scientists use electron microscope to see very small objects inside the cell. Okay, as I have told you that the microscope, light microscope, is simpler. Okay, so it enlarges the image of the object 1500 times bigger. Okay, but the other type of microscope is what? Electron microscope. It is very complex, very sensitive. An electron microscope can magnify the image up to 500,000 times. 500,000 times. So you can imagine how sensitive is it, and how delicate is it, and how wonderful is it to observe anything which you want. Like we have got a cell. You have observed a cell under the microscope. So it is going to be like this. Okay. We have got different organelles here. Okay. So now if you want to observe any part of the cell, what will you do? Your light microscope cannot help you. Okay. So to see inside the cell, we are going to use an electron microscope, because it can enlarge this very part bigger than the size of this cell even. Okay, 500,000 times. So in light microscope, you will use 1500, and here 500,000 times. It shows clear image on a television screen. Okay, so basically you are going to attach it with some screen, and the image of that particular thing will appear on the television. So you can see on a television, everything is so clear and so big. So you can observe these things so much clearly on the television screen, LED even. This microscope uses a beam of electrons instead of light. So instead of using direct light, they have got special kind of electrons. those electrons which are different from the usual electricity and the usual light, basically, not electricity, the light that comes from any bulb or the sunlight or from some torch, any source, that is the direct light. So they use the electrons present in the light, and these are too much sensitive as compared to, and complicated as compared to, the simple light. So these electrons are used to make this image so much clear that it is 500,000 times bigger, but you can still observe it on some screen, okay, television screen, LED screen, anywhere. Okay, dear students, that is all from today's lecture. So we have learned about the cell's basic structural unit, and then to observe the cells, we have got our microscope, the types of microscope, light and electron microscope. So next time, inshallah, we will do our next chapter. Up till then, what you are going to do, you will go through this chapter once again, you will read it and try to understand what is being told, and try to find out the information whatever is given here. Okay, so see you next time. Take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.